don't make a whole lot of money making free videos, so I have to have a second job to make ends meet. I make Blickets. At the end of each week, they give me these options for a pay plan. You know, I go there and I have a whole bunch of Blickets that I've made, and they give me these options. And it's a real pain because I have to sit there and I have to calculate each of the three options to figure out which one's the highest. I want a nice little rule. A nice little rule so I can look at how many Blickets I have, not have to compute it each time and know which option I should choose. So that's what we're going to figure out here. We're going to figure out, you know, what rules I should use to choose from these three options each week. And we'll start by comparing them two at a time. So I'm going to compare option X to option Y. I want to see when is option X better than option Y. Now for option X, I make $375 plus $9 for each Blicket. And I'm going to let B stand for the number of Blickets I make. And I want to see when that is better, is greater than 200 plus 10B. 200 plus 10B is what I make for option Y. Now we're going to isolate the variable here. We'll subtract 9B from both sides, subtract 200 from both sides. Subtract 200 from both sides, we're left with 175 on the left. Subtract 9B from both sides, we're left with the B on the right. And this tells us that if I make less than 175 Blickets, then option X is better for me than option Y. Now let's compare option X to option Z. I'm going to see when X is better than Z. We already know that I make 375 plus 9B for option X. And I want to see when that's better than option Z, which is 450 plus $6 per Blicket. So that's 6B. Once again, we're going to isolate the variable. I'm going to subtract 6B from both sides. I'm going to subtract 375 from both sides. Subtracting 6B will leave 3B over here. Subtracting 375 will leave 75 over there. And I can isolate the B by dividing both sides by 3. And I get B is greater than 25. So if B is greater than 25, then I should choose option X. So I see that when B is between 25 and 175, then X is better than both Y and Z. When it's between, if it's less than 175, it's better than Y. If it's greater than 25, it's also better than Z. So option X is the winner from 25 through 175. And at 175, it doesn't matter which I choose, X or Y. At 25, it doesn't matter which I choose, X or Z. So 25 through 175, I can just pick X, and that'll be the best for me. But I still have to compare option Y and option Z. So let's go ahead and do that. I want to see when is option Y better than option Z. Well, option Y is 200 plus 10B. Option Z, of course, is 450 plus 6B. And again, we just isolate B. We're going to subtract 6B from both sides. That'll leave me 4B over here. Subtract 200. That'll leave me 250 over there. And then we divide by 4. Divide both sides by 4 to isolate B. And we get B is greater than, see, 4 goes into here, 62 2/4, which is 62 1/2. So if I make more than 62 1/2 Blickets, I don't even know what a Blicket is, so how can I tell what a half a Blicket is? But if I make more than 62 1/2 Blickets, then option Y is better. Now I know that option X is the best all the way up to 175, so I'm not going to pick option Y until I get all the way up to 175. But everything from 175 on, everything greater than 175, option Y is the winner. Option Z is better than option Y when B is less than 62 1/2. Now I know I'm not going to pick option Z all the way down to 25. Anything from 25 up to 62 1/2, anything from 25 on, option X is better. So I want option Z only when B is less than 25. So I want everything up to 25. I'm going to choose option Z. And now that I know which option to choose based on how many Blickets I make, I need to go make some Blickets.